Hey guys, welcome you all in the session. In this topic we are going to discuss the poem from grade 7 English. Before I'm telling the topic, we just know something from this picture. So you all know the picture. I don't know, it seems to be a swan, right? And it's young ones. So here the swan is a mother bird, you could see, along with its young one, it's swimming in that river. So we all know the quality of a mother bird, and it has its duty, that the main duty of the mother bird is to save its nest, and also we know save its egg and save its young one. That is what the main thing about the mother bird, right? Yeah. So the topic what we are going to discuss is the mother bird. So let's get into the summary of the poem, and it is written by the poet Walter John D. Lamar. Holmes H. was an English poet, short story writer and novelist. He's probably best remembered for his works for children, for his poem The Listeners, and for highly acclaimed selection of subtle psychological horror stories, among them Satan's Ant and All Hallows. So these are the works of Walter D. Lamar. And let's get into the summary of the poem. In this beautiful poem, the speaker poet looks through the hedge and spots a mother bird guarding the nest. Their eyes meet. The bird seems to be pleading with the speaker to not disturb her. She looks both scared and brave to him. He imagines her heart must be beating quite fast. The bird opens her beak and utters a single cry. It clearly makes a strong impression on the speaker, for he describes it in detail. So you know from this first paragraph what the poet is trying to tell, and the same thing is given in the stanza too. It's all about the speaker. So speaker here, the poet is the poet. He just get into the garden area, or we can get into the forest. There he could notice that there's a mother bird is sitting on the hedge of the tree. There he just saving his nest, just sitting in the branches, and is protecting the nest, right? When he get near to it, when the poet gets near to that bird, it seems to be afraid, and also it seems to be like hopeless. It's like there's no passion in the victory about the expression, I know, about the things happen, how the bird expresses. That's what he given in his verses. He writes that it does not sound like sparrows chirping at the end of the day, nor like a drill that can be heard in a quiet evening. It is a sharp, solitary note which sounds desperate, vivid and fierce, which seems to express both tears and joy, courage and hopelessness, patience and victory. The speaker feels foolish and almost afraid. He quietly moves away from the spot, smiling awkwardly, while the mother bird remains at her nest, a patient and lonely figure. So you can notice the poet is noticing this kind of expressions, this kind of things from that bird. He's just telling it in the place of bird, as what are the things the bird showing to this poet. On seeing that bird, the poet can felt that the bird is looking filled with tears and joys, and seems to be courage and hopelessness, passion and victory. Everything was together. It seems to be that expressions are there. Okay, to capture this brief experience, the speaker poet describes everything, not only how things look but also how different things felt and sounded at that moment. He often uses contrasting words to describe the same thing. The bird's eyes look meekly and brave, and this helps to capture the wide range of emotion that he imagines the bird must be feeling, as well as the strong impression she has on him. He reads a lot into that one cry of the bird. He understands that she is both lonely and brave, hopeless and happy. He feels like he has stumbled upon a private place and moment and must leave the mother bird alone. Compared to the admiration and sympathy he feels for the bird, he himself feels like an awkward and foolish intruder. He leaves but carries the memory of the little bird in his mind. So in this second paragraph, it's all about how the bird looks like. Okay, its eyes look meekly and brave, which is when the poet saw the bird's eye, it seems to be very kind, and also it seems to be a brave bird because it needs to save her nest, right? Yeah. And it helps to capture the wide range of emotion that he imagines the bird must be feeling. So he's just explaining the bird's feeling when he goes near to that bird, what happened in that situation, in that particular spot. He just thinking as a bird what he felt when the intruder came near to him. That's it. So finally he feels himself that he blamed himself that he's that intruder, is a foolish intruder, that he disturbed the bird. That was he has in the mind. And finally he went from the place, has gone from the place, and he carries the memory of that little mother bird, and the things he saw from that bird just carries. And this is how about the summary. And now I'm going to show you the animated video of this poem, and you'll be very clear about that. Then,
green twilight of a hedge, I peered with cheek on the cool leaves pressed, and spied a bird upon a nest. Two eyes she had beseeching me, meekly and brave, and her brown breast throbbed hot and quick above her heart. And then she whipped her dagger bill. 'Twas not a chirp, as sparrows pipe at break of day. 'Twas not a trill, as falters through the quiet even. But one sharp solitary note, one desperate fierce and vivid cry of valiant tears and hopeless joy. One passionate note of victory. Off like a fool afraid I sneaked, smiling the smile the fool smiles best, at the mother bird in the secret hedge, patient upon her lonely nest.